Well, hello there, friends. Pastor Don here, Canonsburg UP Church, on Wednesday, November the 16th. That's right. Just when he thought he could get rid of me, I pop back up. You're probably looking for the notorious K-I-B? No, I can't remember what it is.
K-I-B?
K-I-B. I don't even know what it is, but you can hear him. So I might as well go ahead and... There he is. There
Yo.
He is.
I don't know what that was all about. I told you. Are we both on?
Now we are. Now we're both on.
Are you close enough? I don't want you to get half your head or something.
Yeah, that's always fun.
Well...
So...
Go ahead. You have some things to straighten out about last week. Is that
last
the case?
Last week's video, overall.
Wait, first. This is Don Coleman, pastor here at Canonsburg United Presbyterian Church, 112 West Pike Street, Canonsburg, PA. Also found on the net at canonsburgupchurch.org. And yeah. I'm Kenton Clink. He's the pastor. I'm just a piano player. I don't get why I get video time. Hey. But I take it.
You know? Begged for it. But
begged for it.
So last week's video was great. It was nice to have on-screen producer Al.
It was.
On-screen talent, Al.
He was. Local.
Local, yeah.
Yeah, local talent. Absolutely. I miss him today. Terrible.
Yeah, unfortunately, Al's not with us. He has some appointments to be at.
But he did.
He's getting his teeth cleaned.
He did come earlier and drop off.
Yes.
Scones.
Award-winning.
Scones.
I'll tell you this.
His grandma, Burton.
That's right. So Ethel Burton, who will be 90 soon. She's since, I believe, passed.
Oh, okay.
Because this was several years ago. There's no date.
This is grandma's recipe.
That's right. So
there's two plates in here. One
she's the
Dawn.
Winner for the ethnic foods.
Ethnic.
With the recipe for English scones.
Oh,
yes.
These are English. That's
English
why they're flat.
English scones, yeah.
That's why they're flat.
Her great-grandmother made the recipe, which goes back as far as 1850.
I'm scared to eat them now.
I don't think those were made in 1850.
Oh. You know, some people do strange things with freezers. Although they didn't have freezers
in 1850. They didn't have maybe an ice box.
An ice box. Maybe not even that, though, huh?
Yep. Ethel, I believe, originally from England.
Oh,
yep.
I didn't know Al was English.
Yeah, at least... The Burton family, the Burton side, that so his grandmother, at least,
that
one,
would be his
at least
mother's,
one quarter.
Yep. That would be his mother's.
Well,
right?
It could be his father's mother, right?
Well, no, they would have the same name.
If it was his father's
mother, they would have...
Mother.
It
yeah,
would
you're
be
right. Yes, his Parker. Mother's mother. You're
it
right.
Has
you're
to
right.
Be
Good call. Sorry. Sorry about that. Yep.
Dude, you know, I
mother's
haven't
mother,
lived long
yeah.
enough. I have experience in these matters.
They're a favorite of her grandchildren, these scones,
oh.
and great-grandchildren, and she received the recipe from her mother. So Al let me know that he has become the grandchild who makes them the most and the best, I believe.
Oh, I have no doubt he makes the best.
And I guess his grandmother, he was brought up having tea at every meal.
Really?
That was
hot tea.
He didn't clarify, but that was the guess. That was what I...
Really?
Yeah.
Never talked to him about that.
There you go.
I have to bring it up.
Until this morning, I hadn't either.
Huh.
It reminded me of my grandmother. My great-grandparents were born in England.
Well, you know, he is a man of tradition.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, I mean, really, he's mm-hmm. traditional all the way.
But I do have something to quibble with that he
okay,
said last week.
That I said?
No. Well, I'll get there.
Go ahead, Don.
Something that Al said.
All right. Al.
Something that Al said that I have to...
He's a nice man. You'd be nice.
Very
now.
Nice.
I didn't pay him for last
no,
week.
No, no, no. He had some very nice things to say about me as pastor.
Yes, he did.
But he also said that...
Remember, I got my hand right here.
We're normal. I was with him, and then he said... You know, personable, yeah.
Yeah, you did say personable. Approachable.
Approachable, 100%.
Yeah.
Normal.
Normal, you know, you're right. I didn't catch
and
normal.
It wasn't just me. I'm quibbling with you being normal, too. That's
well,
not, yeah.
Okay, so we're both abnormal.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll accept abnormal.
Okay. All right. The second thing that I had to quibble with.
Yeah.
And you already caught it. So it was Ohio that had the dueling pianos. Yeah, both gifted musicians.
My mistake.
Yeah. Neat.
My mistake.
Yeah. But I was thinking we could get you and Al to play together.
Well, where are we going to get the other piano?
We'll figure it out.
We'll figure it out.
We'll get another one.
We have one right there.
We can do that one. It's not up to, you know, the same level.
But hey,
we could do it.
I mean, if we could get the one from the choir room in here, we could have two.
Yeah, I'm all for that.
That would be cool.
The reason I can say that, so this was the fun thing. So
you can't have my piano yet, okay?
No.
All right.
I wouldn't ask for that. But so back then, what they have still, Liberty Presbyterian Church. If you are in the Columbus, Ohio area, a little bit north of the city, and you're looking for a church, great church. Anyway, so there they have two, and they are both paid musicians.
Oh.
So, but, you know, they take vacation.
Oh, do they?
Right.
See, I don't know.
So here's the coolest thing.
Hmm.
When one of them is on vacation, 9 times out of 10.
The other one?
The fill-in is just a guy.
So it's not even one of them.
They both play.
Yeah.
And then when one of them is on vacation, because actually one of them used to travel, he was kind of bi-coastal. He taught.
Don't call anybody names on my video.
He taught out in Delaware, and he would fly between Columbus and Delaware.
Wow.
Each week. Yeah, he would teach out there, and then we'd come back for Sundays.
That's wonderful.
Yeah. But anyway, so. David Tolley, by the way. But when he was away, or when Steve Banks, who was the other, when they were away, we had a surgeon. It was a surgeon by day. But he could just step in and play.
It wasn't the same.
No, it would in some ways be like, hey, Al can step in and play.
Well, but he needs...
It's not the same as you.
I'm not saying that, but poor Al, he has to practice.
Oh, sure, yeah. Well, it was the same... I'm blanking on his name. But it was the same with him. You know, he wouldn't just sit down and play 45 minutes of music like you could, but...
I wouldn't expect that, but Al couldn't either.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
He needs music.
He needs some music, needs some practice.
And I'm not criticizing Al, I'm not criticizing you.
What's the difference? It's like me, right?
You?
Yeah. So I'm fully convinced that anybody could preach a sermon.
Oh.
Right?
Yeah, oh yeah.
So when I was away,
go ahead.
When I was away last month, Larry Miller preached, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I approached him, and he said, you know, I preached once before back when I was surprised. And then Mike, last week it was Mike. And, you know, both of them have occupations, right?
Yes.
Anybody can preach at least one sermon, one message that people, you know, can share, right?
Well, if they think, yeah, yes.
You prepare it, you give it.
If you have one walking around inside of you.
I think everybody does.
Well, but they have to be willing to let it out. You know, there's that.
I preach, you know, 50 times a year. I can get up there.
And wing it?
I could.
Well, I know.
So the same thing as you play.
52 times a year. Yeah.
And you take some time off. You really should.
Well,
it's healthy.
Anyway, how about this Sunday?
Okay. How
about next month?
Sure. But that's what I'm saying. So the difference is, so you playing, if you know how to play piano, you can play. You need practice. You're doing it all the time. So you just, you know, I'm preaching all the time, so you can just jump in.
Right.
But anybody could, given the time and the preparation, preach.
Well, you have to just be careful they're not ugly.
Oh, they let me up there.
Well,
so, I mean,
that's
what,
true.
What, you know, what can
I never
say?
Thought about that. Yeah. Well,
you're facing the other way, so it's different. You know, it's just the choir that has to have a strong stomach.
Speaking of
choir, gets my best side.
Speaking of, okay.
So Speaking of, he's lost his train.
Boy, I have. Just thinking about what you.
When I was away for one week. Yeah.
So I got, just as you predicted.
Okay.
I'm going to do a program on Sunday, December 4th.
Okay.
The Advent dinner.
Okay.
What time is it?
6 o'clock.
Is it? Do you know that?
It is.
Oh my lordy.
So there was, I know there's been some discussion about this.
Oh my.
So what I went back and I wasn't sure myself. And so I looked at the notes from the session meeting. 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
So
dinner at 6.
We'll be up here at 7. So if you want to skip dinner and just come for the program, you come at 7
don't
o'clock.
Don't skip the best part.
But don't skip the best part. No. Now, speaking of the best part, which is the program, I'm assuming that as you're my pal, you're my buddy, you're my video twin, you're going to do something with me that evening?
Maybe.
Or maybe by yourself? I know you need me to bolster you.
Yeah, I need the support, encouragement.
And also company while you're up there doing it.
You want to play something together, is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Or sing something. Well, we sang before, though.
Did we?
Well, I think the last time I did it, you played and sang.
I feel like...
You were new here when we did that the last time.
I don't feel everything. Yes, when we did the Advent dinner.
Yeah.
When I don't feel like every part of my body is aging, but I do feel like my voice...
Well,
I feel like that is older than the rest of me.
No, it isn't.
I think so.
No, it isn't. Because listen to mine.
I feel it.
Is mine older than I am? Absolutely not. It isn't. I sound much younger. Years younger than I am.
I don't.
Well,
at least not my singing voice.
Well, you have that deep Canadian hockey voice.
Is that what it is?
I don't know.
Neither do I.
I don't. I mean, your mother doesn't have a deep voice.
No.
Does your dad have a deep voice? Did your dad have a deep voice? The boys do. I mean, Aiden does.
Yeah, it's funny. It's funny to think I don't recall my dad having a particularly
How about your grandfather?
Voice. I don't know.
Huh?
You know what I would have loved to known is my great grandfather. I'm starting to pull out some stuff because my great grandfather was a minister.
Mm-hmm.
That was kind of the side of the family. We didn't talk. There's nothing wrong with it. Just there wasn't a lot of connection. But since in the last 10 years or so, learned a lot more about that, and I've got some neat stuff to share. You know, find the right time. I hate making the sermon about me. It's not about me. But there's some ways to bring in some stuff absolutely. That I think is actually pretty cool. So,
well, good.
Yeah. Anyway,
I'm glad your vocation runs in the family.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
My dad had looked into potentially going into ministry years ago too. So
really.
Yeah. I didn't really know too much about that, but.
Well, I never considered going into the ministry.
And here you are.
I guess.
Here you are. Is this ministry?
I guess it is.
You are. Are you gainfully employed in another occupation?
No. It's not at this present time.
No. So this.
I'm thinking about taking
you
in.
You are in occupational ministry. I'm
thinking about cleaning houses and taking in laundry, doing ironing.
If you believe that, I have some oceanfront property in Arizona to sell you.
That's a good one.
Oceanfront problem.
Oh my. Anyway,
endless sea.
I need a commitment from you.
Oh.
About December 4th. I need a commitment.
Sure.
Yes or no?
Sure. We'll figure something out.
I need a yes or no.
Yes. I'm saying the details of which we'll figure
now,
out.
Now, as I let it out of the bag about where you were last week.
Okay.
Everybody knows where you were.
Everybody knows where I was.
Well, everybody that watched.
Everybody wants to know.
Well, yeah. A lot of people didn't care.
I don't.
I mean,
you don't
some
broadcast.
Cared.
It's always a little
some
awkward.
Cared whenever we told them that you were in the hurricane.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, some actually people cared.
We managed.
I'm
a lot
sure
of wind, some rain, mm-hmm. not as.
Mm-hmm. Well,
not
I mean,
danger.
But And everybody knows that I took care of the cats.
You did.
Where's...
I have something for you. You know, I actually brought it down from my room this morning. And as I got in the car a little bit ago, I thought, huh, where is that? Where is that?
Uh-huh, there you go again. Yeah. The last time they went, they brought it home and left it on the plane.
We did. Yeah, a year ago Thanksgiving, we went out and visited Bridget's family in California. And we did. I think there was a hat. I think it was a hat and a t-shirt even.
Oh, wow.
Called the airline.
Oh, well, they're not going to give you a hat and a t-shirt back.
I have something for you.
Okay. I'll get it when I come to dinner tomorrow night.
No, I'm not sure there's going to be anybody there at dinner time tomorrow night.
Well, what do you mean?
Cross country, Canamax cross country banquet.
I thought they had that already.
No.
How many times those kids got to eat?
Yeah, it's like their end of year awards banquet. So.
Oh, I thought they had that already. Yeah,
Bridget is unavailable for that. I will be going, and depending upon the RSVP situation, Aiden and Bria might be going or not. I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Well, then I guess tomorrow night.
I'm here
out.
Tonight. Yeah, yeah.
You can't do it tonight because tonight's a busy night.
Yeah.
For both of us.
Oh yeah, yeah. You've got.
Well, yeah, it's Wednesday.
I'll see you tonight. Well, we might cross paths. We're both here doing different things.
Yeah, we'll be doing much
very different things. Yeah.
You all right there?
Yeah, I'm just trying to give us a little more room here.
We're not unplugged now, are we?
Oh yeah. Nobody can hear us. It's a silent film. Speaking of which, never mind.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So we got that going on December 4th.
December 4th, dinner at 6. Program to follow.
7-ish. This is 1-ish. Sorry we were late today.
Before that.
We had to go
and
eat.
And we need to talk about, we need to see if we can get a special guest next week.
For music?
No, Wednesday. Next Wednesday.
Next
Wednesday. Wednesday, the day before Thanksgiving.
Yeah. We don't have anything.
We need to get a special guest because...
A special guest where?
Here.
Well, there's nothing going on.
Well, the end of the... How many... Oh, we got 2 weeks still?
What?
This is going to be the 20th, right?
I don't know. I don't know what
the 27th.
Date.
Okay. We can wait a week.
I don't understand. You mean in church or on a Wednesday?
No, on Wednesday.
What's on Wednesday?
Nothing's on Wednesday. We want to get a special guest to prepare for what's happening next week.
Oh, you mean a special guest here? Why? Where are you going
to
be?
No, I'll be here with us to join us.
Oh, well, okay. You think?
Yeah.
You have somebody in mind, don't you?
I do.
Let me guess who it is.
Okay, yeah, I don't think you can, but go ahead.
Okay, I can't. Go ahead.
Okay, all right.
Who is it?
I don't know. I'm not going to make any promises.
Okay, then.
But I know what we want to talk about.
Old-fashioned Christmas.
Ding, ding, ding. You know who's going to be a guest downstairs on Friday and Saturday?
Santa Claus. That's the second in the evening and the third all day long. I'm right.
Yes. Yeah.
Dude, I got it.
Yeah,
okay.
Because the 4th is Sunday. For some reason,
right.
I was thinking.
I got it.
Yep. So Friday in the evening, Saturday all day.
Friday's light up night in Canonsburg.
Yeah. We've already got a couple of lights.
Did you see they put lights outside?
One string
That's
of them.
That's hysterical.
I think there's more.
On the grid. I would hope so.
There's more.
I mean, I thought, wow, okay, they were really extravagant here. I mean, I know we're at the end of the whole lighting process.
I'm really hoping there's going to be some more snowflakes on the rest of the street, but maybe not.
I think it kind of ends with us. You know what I mean?
It's all right. It's going to be great.
Oh.
And then, of course, in the following week, right? Or two weeks. 2 weeks after that. So 2 weeks after that, we have the laser lights. Spectacular.
Oh, yes, that's right. Well, what date is that? The 18th?
It'll be Friday and Saturday
16th
again.
And 17th. Yeah, because the 18th would be Sunday, the 25th
there
is Sunday.
There you go.
16th and 17th. I got it.
I'll tell you, the holidays are coming like a freight train.
Oh, they are. And you know what? Speaking of holidays, freight chains and all that, choir members, we need you to come to choir practice on Wednesday nights. We got to get Christmas under our belt.
Wannabe choir members.
want to be choir members. And I mean to tell you, if you got a hankering to sing this Christmas,
yep,
I don't care where you live, where you're from, make the hike to Canonsburg any Wednesday at 7:30. We did some Christmas music already because we only have this rehearsal. There'll be no rehearsal next week because it's the night before Thanksgiving.
Okay.
And too many people are cooking.
Okay.
So I'll be up that night because I'll be assuming you'll be cooking. You making stuffing balls?
We'll see.
Anyway, back to, we need bodies in the choir.
Just bodies, voices.
Well, yeah, voices too. But
the best thing is, I always think, you know, Christmas, Advent and Christmas Eve, you know, you don't have to commit to a whole year.
No, oh my, no. You can come for the season.
Or a lifetime. Yeah, come for the season. It's a great time. Season. I'll tell you, great songs. Yeah. And this Advent season, both our devotional and our series is going to be highlighting some of the great Christmas carols, Christmas hymns.
I had a special request to write. I haven't honored the request yet.
Are you going to write?
I don't know because I'm so packed up now with these other musical things. Because on the 12th of December is the Active Christian Seniors Luncheon, Christmas luncheon. Yes.
Yeah.
And so that begins at 11 o'clock downstairs
in
the sanctuary. And the entertainment will be Jan Patch Taylor of Malone's Flower Shop creating something.
Okay.
And then after
she's done,
I don't know.
Okay.
And then after she's done, we're going to do a little singing and maybe a little clowning around. I don't know.
Okay.
And then the people will have lunch at noon.
Okay.
So that's on the 12th of December.
Okay.
So you guys are just taking up my time here. And you wonder why I don't put up a tree.
I don't.
Well, but I can't believe you still drag a live one through the house.
Well, we'll
Clark
see.
Clark Griswold.
We'll see, yeah.
Clark Griswold, really. Now, I don't know what you're going to do.
I'm not putting in a pool, though.
True.
Not expecting any bonuses.
No.
So.
No.
And I would be happy with Jelly of the Month Club.
Well, you know what? Used to have a T-shirt that said Jelly of the Month Club.
Nice.
Yep. Well, I don't have it anymore.
No.
But you said something. Swimming pool. No swimming pool. Although.
Jelly. Hot tub would be cool, but.
Well, put it out there, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you clean up what I told you to clean up, by the way?
I didn't.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
But I was
gonna anyway. Your little kitten.
Okay.
That's Oreo. What I was going to talk about Oreo.
Yep.
And I lost it now.
I think she should be like double stuffed. I think that would be
double
she's,
stuffed.
She's
would be
more concerned. White than black.
True.
We're also last year we went to California for Thanksgiving. This year, Bridget's dad, my father-in-law,
is coming,
and just him.
I want to meet him.
You've met him before. He's been here.
Have I?
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, Honduras. He went to Honduras several years ago.
Oh, that's right.
That's where Aiden gets his height from.
Okay, really? Mm-hmm.
Yep, he's 6'3", 6'4".
Oh, okay. I never noticed.
Yep.
I didn't remember.
So, at least he was. I mean, he's...
Well, I mean, Brennan's not a little kid either.
Nope.
I mean, Aiden is going to pass everybody up.
Yeah, he's already ahead of me.
Is he?
Yeah. I'm about the same as he is.
I'll bet he's all excited about that.
Yep.
I'll bet he's all excited about that.
And, you know, we should probably mention one other thing that is a little bit of a important thing for
everybody?
8 days from now.
8 days from now, which would be Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving dinner. So if you are looking for a Thanksgiving dinner, A, absolutely free of charge. B, it is in person as well as takeout. So if you're watching this and you don't have any family or friends around for Thanksgiving, come. If you're watching this and you're stuck at home, you're not mobile, you can contact us, and we do some deliveries.
Yes, I know.
So wonderful Thanksgiving.
497 pieces of pie, something like that.
I don't know. It's
they
it's
had a number last
it's
week.
It's a lot. Yeah. It's,
wow. I've never been.
To
the dinner.
Yeah, I've rarely been able to, but.
And then we also have Toys for Tots going on, too.
Toy Chest, yeah. I off the top of my head, I've forgotten when the registration, I think that's next week.
I think it's happening right away.
I think Monday and Tuesday registration for that. But
yeah. So that's nice. That's a
lot of great things going on.
That's Lindley Caliguire.
Yo, Lindley's wonderful.
Working on that. Yeah. She's very dedicated to that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so there's a lot of things going on this month.
A lot of things going on, a lot of good things.
A lot of good things, yeah. Well, you know, we don't talk about the bad stuff. You want to talk about some bad stuff?
I don't know.
Me either.
I don't know. That would go against everything I'm saying Sunday, so no.
This Sunday?
Yep.
Are you talking about good stuff
this Sunday? Yeah, good stuff.
Try not to mention me by name.
I'll try really hard.
Okay, because, you know, I know naturally when you think good stuff.
First thing that comes to mind.
I know.
Yeah.
The sparkling
Kenton's
face, yeah. I mean, I missed it out.
Shines.
Shines.
Under the light.
Shines.
Off the Golden Dome.
Did you also go in, when you listened to last week's video,
yep.
Did you hear that Al and Linda, or Al offered, I could come spend the night. Go in the refrigerator where I wanted to.
Wow.
They would make coffee for me and breakfast in the morning.
That was the other thing I was going to quibble about, actually.
What? What's that?
I'm good in a medical emergency.
Oh, no.
Just
Did
one,
you listen to the whole story?
Just one person that I... Yeah,
thanks. Okay.
Just you.
When I really needed
when
you.
When you really... You didn't.
I had a wound right there. A wound. An open wound.
It wasn't open.
Well, it was covered up with plastic.
I came and saw you in the hospital. I even tried to help out.
Don't tell them what you did, okay?
Oh, I found some...
Go ahead.
I found some Du Maurier. That's a Canadian brand.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, Marlboro. No, what are you, Lucky Strike?
Oh, my goodness. No, now you know what I smoke.
I don't remember. What are you...
Come on.
I don't remember.
Oh, they're in the car.
Good.
Cools. Yeah.
I could totally see there's a little
years.
Young little Kenton. Oh, that looks cool.
No.
That's what it was.
I was at least 17.
Really? Took you that long?
Oh, yeah. Okay. In fact, Kenny smoked first.
Mm, but he gave it up, didn't he?
No,
he's still smoking?
Yeah. He and I are probably the last two smokers. My brother Jerry does smoke a cheroot once in a while. That's a cigar.
Okay.
Right. He smokes those, but he was a cigarette smoker too, but not anymore.
I kicked them under the bed when I found them.
Yeah, he did. And I crawled under the bed.
Because I left them there when I left. I tried to help.
I couldn't call a nurse and say, hey, could you get the
cigarettes? You
could
have.
Well,
it wouldn't have surprised me in the least.
Well, I that was the hospital stay. They sent the smoker police to my room. They did. And they said, Mr. Clink, are you smoking in
Mr.
there?
Mr. Clink, there's oxygen. You can blow up the entire
hospital. No, I wasn't using
hospital.
Oxygen. I was in the room by myself.
Well, they've got oxygen there.
Well, it's not in my room.
Yeah, they're all outfitting with them.
Not on.
Well, that's...
And even if it is, my God, you got to get right on it. Okay?
Have you tried?
No. I'm not stupid.
How would you know?
I mean, I want to smoke in the hospital. But yeah, they...
He's the guy that comes out of the... to get his own gas and is dangling down there. He's like...
They sent. I felt really bad because I had shut the door because...
of course.
I was changing my clothes when the smokers police showed up. And so they thought I had them locked out. And here I said, no, I don't have any pants on. And they were like, let us in. This is the smoke police.
Not...
And what's really
hair
funny
on
is
my
that
chinny
when
chin
they
chin.
Open door,
yeah.
You could smell cigarette smoke so bad. Oh, well. I smoked it in every...
Well.
What was that?
That's a reminder to pray.
That was your...
To pray for my wife, yeah.
For your wife?
Mm-hmm.
That was her talking?
No.
Was that the bells ringing?
No, it's just it's a song that...
She sings.
No.
What was the song?
I can't think of the title right now.
Sing it for me.
Hold on. It's More Heart, Less Attack.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really clever.
Why do you say that about heart attack?
Okay.
I we probably should. I worry about you.
Okay.
In that area, and I don't know why.
Huh. My dad had a couple aneurysms.
Did he?
Yeah.
Have you ever been checked?
Yep. Got checked out a couple years ago.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, it was fine.
They do your head too?
No. My grandfather, never. Nobody has a brain aneurysm.
Oh, my brother had brain.
Yeah. No, my grandfather on my mom's
side. My dad had abdominal.
Yeah, yeah. No.
Aortic, yeah.
Yeah, aortic. Yeah.
Kenny has a little one now.
Okay.
He also has a spot on his lung, but he's still sucking on them cigarettes. I can't think of what he smokes. I can't think. They're not the same as me. I think he might smoke Marlboro Lights. We're going to have everybody a commercial today. But anyway, that was the way I started smoking was where I worked. If you walked away to smoke a cigarette from your job,
you got a break.
You got a break. If you didn't smoke,
that's always what works. Yeah.
So I thought, well, I got to smoke. So I picked. I picked up the first thing, and there it was, a Kool from my friend Dan, the same one that I went to see The Exorcist with. Mm. He smoked Kools. Yeah.
No thanks. Not worth it, man. Let me work through.
What? Oh no,
Not worth the 5 minute break.
You know, you're a teenager. You're standing there all greasy.
What kind of? It was a.
I was flipping burgers at Eaton Park. Yeah.
17. Yeah. I was running a Ferris wheel. Yeah.
Well, at my young age, I was the manager always used to say, no. The waitresses would get backed up in the front room mm-hmm. when there was rush hour.
Mm-hmm.
And there would be always nobody there at the cash register to take money.
Mm-hmm.
So there'd be a line out the door for people to pay. And they wouldn't trust anybody to run the cash register.
They trusted
register.
You.
They would say, Ken, go out and ring people up. Can you imagine that?
No.
And the thing about it is that was a prelude to what I did for the rest of my life. I took people's money.
You took people's money.
Yeah, still do it.
Two for you, one for me. I understand
well,
how that goes.
I try to work that out like that. It never really did, though, because somebody always counted it after and checked.
I hope so.
Well, what do you mean you hope so? You just assume I'm going to, like...
No, but when you say it like that you tried, I'm like...
Well, look, if you want to steal, you have to be good at stealing.
Yeah. I'm gonna say no. I'm gonna say no.
You can't take a whole chunk at one time.
Just don't take any of it.
Skim. No, I know it's wrong. That's terrible. I don't want to teach bad things. Look, do not try that at home. Okay.
Or at your place of employment. Wow.
Well,
we're.
You know. Remember. I just remember.
You
when
were
I
young,
started,
impressionable.
When I started to
questionably
work,
moral young
when
man.
When I started
yes.
to work. In retail, cigarettes were like 65 cents a pack. Okay?
They were never 65 cents a pack in Canada.
Really?
No, the tax. That's how
oh.
they... There were two ways that they reduced... There are three ways that they reduced the number of people who are smoking in Canada. One, they taxed them out of the... Yeah, that's why people would steal them, because they were worth more than money. Tax them. And then they started putting, you know, tremendous warnings. I think they've even got pictures.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And then the third one is basically you can't smoke anywhere. So
now, you know, the first attorney general, mm-hmm. Surgeon yep. General was that put he came
Surgeon
on TV.
General
and
Warner, yeah.
Who was you know it? Who it was?
No.
C. Everett Koop.
And
don't ask me why I remember that. But smoking can cause lung cancer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, came right out there.
No, good.
And well, you know, but in the 50s and 60s, mostly in the 50s and 40s, actually, before that,
oh, yeah.
they were unfiltered cigarettes.
Yeah.
Not that the filter, but... And then, you know, people don't understand there's a different... We shouldn't be talking about this.
Justifying cigarette smoking. Yeah, I don't think
no,
it's...
No,
yeah. It's better not.
I mean, you can hear me wheezing from... On the other side of the country.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You've heard that yourself.
That's why I can go on vacation and walk 20,000 steps a day and be okay.
Where I couldn't make it through Kennywood. Of course, it was 1,000 degrees that day.
Yeah.
And the only
and reason, now it's
and let me tell you about that Kennywood trip, because we got out of the car in the parking lot and he's sunscreening himself up.
And you're bending and, over.
No. He's sunscreening himself up, you yep. know, getting ready to go. And he looks at me and says, I forgot my wallet. Now, is that a shock to you?
Did I really forget my wallet?
Yeah, well,
I think I was joking. I was pretty sure I was joking.
When the kids went to the potato patch, Brennan came right up to me and said, Kenton, you brought money, didn't you?
I had money.
That trip to the potato patch, that cost me $40.
Yeah, it's not
those
cheap.
Those kids are expensive.
Yeah.
That's why I never bought any.
Bought any kids?
Kids, yeah. That is how you get them, isn't it? I've never been to a kid's store. See how that works?
Yeah.
To you? You see how that works?
So, you don't have to.
Well, I know that.
But I think we're running out of time.
Let's talk about
God
first.
We're running out of time.
Let's talk about God first real quick, because, mm-hmm. you know, that's why we're here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you know, the big emphasis in Mike's sermon last Sunday was, mm-hmm. Son of David, have mercy on me. And it was really good. And I've been actually using that in my prayers since then. I mean, not to have mercy on me, but Son of David, have mercy on me. And of course, Mike talked about the blind man. And mm-hmm. But, you know, Mike talked about the importance that the blind man threw away his cloak and walked with the crowd to go. I think that was important because that cloak would have been valuable to that blind man, but not as valuable as his sight.
Mm-hmm.
There were a lot of things going on there that day between Jesus, the people,
yep.
and that blind man,
yeah.
And how they tried to repress him because he wasn't exactly the most savory of individuals,
mm-hmm.
in their group. But we always have unsavory individuals, like the black sheep, mm-hmm. of the family.
Mm-hmm.
Were you the black sheep of your family? I'm not sure I was. If you ask any other one, they would say,
yeah,
you were. But I don't think I am. And so Thanksgiving this year, you're cooking at home.
I believe so.
And your father-in-law is coming.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so you're not running out to Cracker Barrel.
I mean, tried to go to Cracker Barrel earlier over the weekend, and
it was packed.
Oh man!
Well, it is. What day was that? Sunday. Mm-hmm. It would be on a Sunday afternoon.
Yeah.
I mean, you should have went earlier, if anything. But I realized that was your first day home from Disney World. I, being the kind of person that I am, we do church last week. I know that the Colemans are home, and so I took my time. I mean, I left church. I went and had my lunch with my friend Cheryl, and I got back in the car and I drove over to Dawn's house. Tried the front door; it was unlocked, and I thought, "Okay, we're a go." So I went in, and all I saw was empty glasses on the dining room table. I yelled hello. Nobody there. It was just like the rest of the week. Yeah. The cat came downstairs and wanted fed too.
Yeah. Yeah. Well,
I didn't feed him.
Habit.
Well, yeah. I didn't feed him though. But there I was sitting in the living room. Nobody's there. So I called him up on the phone. I said, "Where are you?" He told me where he was. And naturally, I didn't get an invitation to come where they were. Of course not. Yeah, you had just sat down.
Okay.
I could have been there in 10 minutes.
There's no room at the table.
That's a flimsy excuse. Your mom would have scooched over.
Maybe, yeah.
She would have. Or I would have just picked the kid and say, "Hey, you go sit someplace else." You know, they're kids.
I think it's time for me to scooch over now, though.
Scooch?
Mm-hmm.
Don't come no closer.
No.
Where are you scooching to?
I'm scooching away.
And then what do you want me to do?
If you'd like to go to the piano, you can, but you don't have to.
Piano.
You don't have to.
Oh, ask the people out there. We have to give the people
what
they want.
There's nobody left.
Yes, sir. There's always at least two watching.
It's always at least two.
Yep.
Well,
if it worked.
If it worked.
Yeah. I mean, we got Kathy.
We got
Kathy watching. We got Sandy.
Maybe, yep.
Oh, yeah. We got Sandy Hill watching.
I didn't check.
And I'm sure we do. And we got Cheryl watching.
Okay.
Al couldn't watch yet, but he will be.
Okay. You going to play something for us?
I don't know. Those scones look pretty good.
Little Thanksgiving music?
You know what? You did pick. Why didn't you pick? I understand Count Your Blessings, but you got all those other ones. Come Be Thankful, People Come, all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's in there.
Well,
isn't that one in there?
You picked.
There's two Thanksgiving songs. We're going to sing them both.
No.
We're going to sing two Thanksgiving songs Sunday. Yeah.
What are they?
I can't remember the other one off the top of my
head. We Gather Together.
Yeah, there you go.
Count Your Blessings.
There you go. That's two. Yeah.
That's two.
Yeah. Those are two.
I thought you just said three.
No, two.
No, three. Two. No, two. There you go with those fingers again. You got them little stubby fingers. Look, that's a little stubby finger. Look. No, look.
Let's see. You got little size. Yeah. Look, mine's bigger.
All right. Yeah.
My hands.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, if you think for one second that he pulled out his wallet and bought lunch again today, and I had to use another credit card because, again, someone is trying to commit fraud on my credit card. So I had an extra to pull out, thank goodness. Not yours.
I'm the one committing fraud.
I wouldn't be the first time.
Not the first. Won't be the last.
No, it wouldn't be. Are you? What's happening now?
One of two things are happening.
Have we recorded the whole time?
It looks like it.
Okay.
Kathy's here. Michelle's here.
Uh-huh. Michelle. She's a good girl. Who else?
I don't know. Let me see here.
What are you doing?
I'm checking. Let's see.
Okay.
Here.
Don't turn us off. Who else is watching?
Oh, Kathy said she shampooed hair when she was 17.
Oh, there you go.
Ashley, Cheryl.
I told you, Cheryl.
Those are the only four that I know for
Ashley's
certain.
Ashley's watching, too. Yeah, she's a good girl.
But it says there's six whole people that are still with us.
What about Judy? Is Judy there?
It doesn't say.
Judy's not feeling good.
It doesn't mean that she's not. It just doesn't say.
My friend Judy Ritchie, she doesn't feel good.
Yeah.
No,
now we're down to five.
Uh-oh.
Now that you're going to play piano, nobody wants to.
Did you disconnect the voices yet?
Not yet, no.
Okay, you're doing so well so far. You didn't mention my flannel shirt today. Not a thing about it. And why?
We're just looking at the flannel shirt. Is that what you wanted to show off?
Well, what's that? Oh, I see. Are you sure your thumb is on camera now?
Mm-hmm.
That's very neat. Mm-hmm. I don't want to go too close to the camera.
Kathy says play Kenton.
Who?
Kathy.
Aww.
I mean, she's been waiting long enough.
Kathy, since you said that and not him, you got it, honey. Whatever you want. Here comes some music for Kathy.
Thank you. song. Have you never let someone else, big note, be strong?